I want to apologize for having pushed that mindset that you find so often in the anti-SJW crowd, that, you know, pretty much the sky is falling, everything's gonna come apart if we question too much more about the current systems, and we pick it apart too much more, it's gonna just start to crumble. And I'm like, I don't think we've actually reached anything even close to that level yet. I think it will probably eventually happen, but the systems we have are more likely going to crumble as a result of automation and a number of other things than because some things in society change, some attitudes in society have changed about a number of things. Giving people more choices in ways they can live is not destroying this country. Being more open and accepting is not destroying this country. There are a lot of issues that need to be worked on, especially in the men's issues department, in boys' issues department. Boys' issues department. Yeah, that's some great grammar there. But we have a lot of work to do in those areas. We can't just let half the youth of the population just kind of let them go by the wayside. You can't just do that. It's not going to be good. Yes, we need to keep helping and doing things in support of the other half. Definitely keep that up, but we also need to support the male half of the population, the boys. They're important. One of the things that's been so disappointing in comments lately, they're not my latest uploads, I'll just say that. The attitude is very similar to Black Pigeon Speaks in this. They think that giving so many options and giving women the ability to have any sort of power at all has destroyed society. And they always sort of word it as in past tense. I don't think our society is destroyed. A lot of, if you do look at statistics, standards of living and crime rates and just a number of factors, we're doing pretty good. We're actually doing pretty good. A lot of people are pretty angry on social media. But if you step away from it for a while and just experience life a little more, the importance of some of this shit that goes on these platforms goes way down. Most people just want to live their lives. But I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I was in some of that group of people essentially yelling, "The sky is falling." I still believe in these three, that there are three pillars that hold our society together: control, manipulation, and ownership. And any one of those that crumbles, the other two will fall for sure. But we're not there yet. We're not. It's far off. Like I said, automation is more likely to put an end to these systems that we have right now than anything else. Or if a war destroys the country, like if Washington D.C. gets bombed or something, there'd be a problem, right? There are people who proclaim that anything that goes any further left than the DNC, you're heading on your way to Stalin, Pol Pot, that we're heading in this direction that's just for absolute doom of anything that goes, like I said, further to the left than the DNC. That's some fear mongering. I understand you used to be on the left and you learned some things and now you feel differently, but sort of like how Dennis Miller used to be liberal and then he switches and then just kind of becomes an asshole and kind of stops caring about any other demographic but his own. And I've seen this happen. I guess this is... It's just disappointing to see when that happens to people. That's the mindset they're in. There's nothing that's going to change their mind. Once someone is in that mode, you know, as long as I get mine and the majority of people get theirs, you know, the majority of people who have the majority mindset, they get theirs, fuck everyone else. And it's so disappointing to see that, to see people adopt that mindset. But I don't know where I'm going now, so with this video, so...